If only there was a simple way to add a wow effect to your cards. I have an idea for that, and it's not hard. Even better, you can do it while you're working on your card, so it doesn't take much extra time or effort. Let me just show you. Today I'm going to work with some papers in some really gorgeous colors by Just Lou, the Mindful Moodling line, along with stencils, and I have a die set with sentiments. There are lots more products in this line, and I will link to that in the description box below if you want to check that out. Today I'm going to do something different. I cut a card out of a piece of scrapbook paper, so I used the paper itself to make my card. And that will be my card base. And I did the same for my second card, because I'm going to make two cards. I cut that also out of a piece of scrapbook paper. And along with that, I'm going to use some envelopes. And I have a piece of smooth and sturdy card that I cut slightly smaller than my card. I'm working a little bit backwards today. I've cut my sentiment already. I've cut it out of the scrapbook paper. I've also cut it out of the smooth and sturdy card. Smooth and sturdy is a bit thicker, so that will give me some nice dimension on my card. I've added a bit of glue on a scrap piece of paper, and now I'm going to add my glue on top of the sentiment. Then I put the sentiment I cut out of the scrapbook paper on top of that. I just put the scrapbook paper sentiment slightly offset on the smooth and sturdy sentiment. This will give you a nice shadow effect as well, as it stands out a little bit more. Next, I have the stencils that I showed you in the beginning. I put a towel on my desk with the spray safe tool and my smooth and sturdy card. And next to it, I have the envelope with the stencil. And then I spray some of the shimmer spray. And then I spray my card. And I also spray the envelope, but I also only spray one corner of the envelope. And this will give you a really fun half-colored envelope. And this is very easy to do because you already had those sprays, so it doesn't take much more time and your envelope is nicely decorated. The stencil is still a little bit wet, so I'm going to press it on my card. I'm just checking the best place to add it, and then I use a piece of kitchen paper to press it down. By the way, I'm using the towel because that will take up any excess ink, which makes it a bit less messy. I made sure my sprayed card was dry. Now I add the stencil, and then I'm going to use two more colors of the spray. I spray while I move to the right, and then you spread the spray a little bit more, so that's easier to color a bigger surface. Also, you don't want to add too much of the spray because that will just drip under your stencil. And then I'm going to blot, and this will make a nice background base. So I'm going to make my envelope match my card now. So I add the stencil back in place, and then I'm going to add a bit of the other two sprays. And then I carefully take off the stencil. And now you have a matching envelope with the card in the same colors. I'm going ahead and color my second card as well. I want a real vibrant pink color, so I color the complete background and I don't spray any water to dilute it. I let it sit for a bit and then I just blot. And I take my bright pink envelope, I added the stencils on top of that, and I add some of the spray. And then I carefully take off the stencils. When you're working with stencils like this, make sure you don't wait too long to lift them. You want to do that, well, basically right away. Next, I've added my dry card to the makeup station. I add the stencil on top, and then I added my magnets. And then I'm using a palette knife to add my texture paste. I'm using texture paste transparent matte, but you can also use the gloss. For the technique I'm going to do, it doesn't matter if you use the gloss or the matte, because that won't show anymore. So I just add the paste over the complete card. Then I take off the stencil carefully. This is how it looks with the paste. The paste will stay wet for quite a bit, so you have time to clean your tools. Next, I'm going to add some gold embossing powder, and I spread that over the complete background, making sure that I only touch the sides and not too much of the middle. And then I'm going to melt the embossing powder. And now something really cool happens, because the paste is going to bubble because it wasn't dry yet. And in this case, it's a really good thing because it gives you some extra texture, which is always cool, free texture. And the end result is super cool because it's really soft and squishy. So I think this worked really well. On the envelope, I also added a few details with the paste with the stencil back in place. And I'm going to add some of the embossing powder, and then I'm going to melt that also. And now it's time to assemble my first card. I have cut a strip from the patterned paper, and I'm going to distress the edges. This will give me a bit of texture and also some white, which will make it stand out from the background a little bit more. And I cut a few of the circles that were on the page. And now I'm going to add parts of the circles behind my strip to let them pop out from under. And I also have a few smaller pieces that I add to the back of the strip. And adding small details like this is a really fun way to use up your pattern paper. And it will make sure that you have matching parts and pieces to add to your card. And this is something that we have done in the craft along about pattern paper. And I will add a link to that in the description box below if you'd like to check that out. In the meantime, I added my sentiment to the strip and I'm going to add the complete strip to the card. I bended the ends of the sentiment a little bit to make it fit on my card. And I fold the edges of the strip around my card, which I think gives it a nice touch also. And then I add the complete card panel to the scrapbook paper base card. I finish with some gold stickles. There are some gold elements in the paper and this is a nice way to bring them out and make them pop even a little bit more. And I add a few tiny dots with the stickles also. And then I'm going to put my card aside to dry and this won't take very long with the tiny dots and with stickles. I think about an hour or so. And I have a few more pieces that I'm going to add to my envelope. And this will make it a really great surprise for anyone who will receive this in his mailbox. And this is another great way to use up some leftover pieces. And because I added the bigger piece over the fold of the envelope, I'm going to fold it right away after I glued it in place. And this will make sure that the envelope still can close and the paper stretches a bit. And this was so easily done by adding a few elements to the envelope to make it matching to my card. And then the next card, I have my card panel and I'm going to distress the edges. This will also give me a bit of white and some texture. And I basically like both. Then I'm going to tear some V-shapes and I'm tearing it to the back so the color stays on the front. I also distress them a little bit so there is some white here and there but not over the complete piece. I'm going to tear a few more V-shapes. And then I'm going to add a few of the elements that I fussy cut from the paper that was left over from this card to the back of my card panel. I always like to make things pop out from under. This gives a really fun touch to a card. And it's always nice to do that in different ways. And sometimes I cut up pieces even smaller so you can spread them behind several V-shapes. You don't need a lot. You can use up all your scraps for this. Then I've added some tape to the back of my card. Then I'm adding it in place on my card base. Now I'm going to layer the elements that I cut out. And now I find that the sentiment doesn't stand out as much as I wanted on the colored circles. So I'm going to change up my plan a bit. Move the sentiment to the top. That's not working for me. Maybe you like it, but I didn't. So I'm moving the circles to the top now. And then I add my sentiment below the circles. And I like this look way better. But my sentiment is a little bit too big for my card, but I think I'm going to solve that. I probably will. So I'm going to glue the circles in place first, because I already know that I want them there. Assembling the card and layering all the elements and moving them around like this is one of the most fun parts in card making and crafting in general for me. And then I'm going to play with the sentiment a little bit. I add the word with already because that's in a good spot. And then I'm going to cut off a part of the word love. And I'm going to put that piece below it. I think that's a nice way to use the sentiment also. A bit different, but that's what crafting is about, right? Making it your own. Then I'm going to finish my envelope with a few more of those circles that I cut out. They also came out of the same piece of pattern paper. I add two circles to the side and one on the flap of the envelope. And I think this makes another really nice set. So what do you think? Are you ready to dive in? Or do you need some more inspiration? You can find some right here. And as always, make sure to keep on crafting.